Easy now. Yep. There, girl. Easy. There we go. Okay then. Thank you. Yeah. Easy, easy. Easy now. Okay there. Slow up now. Yep. There we go. Thank you.
Looking horse you got there. How about we see how fast it is? First one of Catfish Jackson's. So what do you say? Well, what'll it be then?
Don't forget to go hunting, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, I hear you.
Good.
Very nice. We should get top dollar for this. Many thanks, Mr. Morgan. Hey, if you're struggling for space in your satchel, just bring me the right materials and I'll work something up for you.
Okay. Thank you.
You know, Arthur, I can always make you a new satchel if you're tight on space.
How are you, Mr. Morgan?
How you doing, Mrs. Adler?
How are you? Been quite a journey since I joined you fellas.
Yes.
And now you and Dutch have joined high society. My lord above.
Yeah, it seems so.
I think my days in polite society are over.
Well, I just saw Bill Williamson at a party at the San Denise mayor's house. If he can do it, anyone can.
You get any leads?
Yeah, I think so.
You know so, Arthur Morgan. Come on. We need to talk. Mrs. Adler, will you excuse us?
When are you going to let me come robbing with you, Dutch?
My lord, a few more like her, we could take over the whole world.
A few more like her, there wouldn't be much of a world left.
Yes, perhaps.
Now, the trolley bus station. I went down there. I took a look at it. I think we can hit it.
I ain't never robbed in a city before.
Well, you leave the planning to me. You'll ride with me.
Always. Is it just you and me?
No, we'll need one more, I reckon.
I say Lenny.
Not Micah.
Well, that depends if you want a massacre or a payday.
No, I wish that there was something I could do to make the two of you get along better.
Well, that's easy. Make them change.
Very funny. What is that?
What the hell have they done to me?
Look, there in the tree line.
Everybody take cover! O'Driscoll boys are coming!
Windows covered quickly. John, you take the windows over there. Charles, you take the side doors there. Arthur, you take the windows in the back. Go!
okay?
I think so. Except for Karen here. Poor kid. Mr. Swanson, would you take this boy and bury him someplace near, but not too near?
Of course. Charles, help me with the body.
We need to get this place cleaned up. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw!
Already taking care of it. Come on now, work!
Como O'Driscoll. That man can really hate. So can I, Arthur. So can I. We need to get moving. Away from here.
So we should start looking for another camp.
You ain't thinking big enough, Arthur. You ain't seeing the vastness of our problems and our opportunities.
I'm not sure I get you.
You will, son. You will. Meet me near the trolley station. We got work.
Shall we?
Yep.
Kieran, that poor kid we spared from O'Driscoll's gang up in the mountains is dead. They chopped his head off and tried to kill the lot of us. Whole place gives me the creeps. You all right, Reverend?
Just trying to make sense of this. I'm scared.
Easy, killer.
That's rich from you.
I ain't trying to row you. Believe me.
How about you keep your temper this time, hmm?
Farewell.
Can you believe I just heard one of them demand an equal treatment to us whites? I mean,
well, quite the price tag on little old you.
Good morning
Bye.
To you.
Come on, girl.
Good girl.
You good girl?
Came.
Of course I came. Said I would.
There's a foreman. His name is Danbury. It's the files in the office above the refinery room. It's that window with the blind drawn up.
I see it.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm coming. What will the files say?
There'll be a report from Leyland Oil Development Company.
And you got the money?
Yes.
Any ideas how I sneak into this place?
You could crawl under the fence or hide in a wagon. They keep rolling in.
I'll go take a look.
If there's a problem, call for me.
I thought the whole point was that this had nothing to do with you.
Ideally.
If you are cool, you could climb into the back of that wagon.
Thank you.
you are quick. You could climb into the back of that wagon. Otherwise, you'll have to sneak past the guards.
The early train to Saint Denis.
Okay. Better get a move on then.
Yourself, friend. This won't take long. Danbury.
Yes?
I need some papers, my friend. Nothing important. A file. I'm from head office.
You're not from head office?
Does that seem important right now?
No.
I need a file by the Leland Oil Development Company. The one about the oil near Wapiti?
I...
Danbury. Think, man. A Mind is a terrible thing to lose. Especially over such a nice floor as this.
It's here! It's here!
Good, Danbury. Real good. They'll give you a promotion for this. No, Danbury.
Danbury? Danbury, you okay?
Tell the guard you're fine.
Yes, it's just... I'm working. All's fine.
Now stay quiet. Or head office will send me back to get you. Fellas.
Now, we won't tell you again.
I was happy to watch some of that oil burn. So you met Mr. Danbury?
Yes, don't worry. He was very obliging. I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were gonna enter and leave silently.
Thank you. You saved my life.
Thank you. I hope. Well, I don't know what I hope. But who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Thank you.
Some sort of problem?
Ah, it's you. Hello, mister. Ah, I recognize that face. Okay, let's see. Picked this up off the street, no doubt. Come across a few of these myself. Oh, yes. People lose these all the time. This must be an heirloom, huh?
Much appreciated.
Got a little kick show in mind, huh? All sorts of unusual ways to acquire goods in this world. I'm not one to judge.
Yeah.
Easy, whoa. Here. Easy now. Yep. This is very kind of you. Up you get.
Take me to damn court then. Thank you. This ain't America. We ain't... Can't raise no animals, take no wives. All I did was graze my livestock. Married them that needed marrying. And killed any that tried to stop it.
Sounds like sour grapes. You know, you ain't going to court. You ain't going to jail either. I'm taking you to a professor I know.
What in hell are you talking about?
You're a lucky man, mister. You get to be part of a great experiment.
Shut up!
Huh? You ain't gonna die needlessly, is what I mean. Nope. Your death's gonna be an important step in the advancement of human knowledge.
What in hell you saying, mister?
This professor, Andrew Bell III, I believe he said. He's a little odd, maybe harebrained, but I got no reason to doubt the quality of his work.
What's this damn professor got to do with anything?
Well, he wants to try this new electric... ...electricity chair on you. To kill you. Humanely.
No!
Yeah. Well, he's gonna strap you into this contraption and run a large electric current through your system. Got something to do with moonshine. Don't quite know what. I guess that's why he's the professor and I'm the bounty catcher. But as I said, I can pass on his assurances that this is a most humane way to go. It'll be just like, well, like switching off a light.
They wouldn't let you do this to me. They wouldn't.
Oh, they would. And we got a permit and everything. You was in animal husbandry, am I right? You ever seen lightning strike livestock, Mr. McDaniel? I ain't ever seen the actual impact, but I came across the pasture sometime after. The storm had just cleared, and there was smoke in the air, smell of burning hair.
No.
There must have been a dozen head of cattle lying there, piled up, mangled. Strange scars across their backs, legs, and necks. It's half like they was burned, half like the skin was ripped off.
No!
Eyes bleeding, some of them popped out.
No!
If I hadn't seen the storm, well... Ah, shit. You're gonna be all right. Look at the floor for a bit. It's okay, girl. Just a scratch. There, girl. All right. Thank you.
Sorry about that, McDaniels. You all right? Yeah, me too. Well, you'll be happy to know we ain't got far to go. Hold on tight now.
Looking for trouble. Come on, move it.
Well, here we are. The professor will be real pleased to meet you.
No!
Bring him
here.
To me.
I got him.
You're wonderful. Just
come on.
Wonderful.
Don't be shy now. Let's go.
Bring him over here.
Now, where's my money?
Money?
Yeah, for all the running around I've been doing.
Oh, well, once they buy my humane electric ending facilitator, there'll be money enough for you, sir.
Yeah, let's hope.
All right, let's get our poor unfortunate ready for the demonstration. Oh, do come and watch. It'll be amazing. Come along.
You trying to piss me off?
Are you slow?
There you are. Come on, keep walking. You're late.
A couple of days in this place, you turned into some clock-watching city boy. What's the urgency?
We need to leave. Forever. We've been doing well, making money. But for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat. Now, I found a friendly ship captain. He's willing to take us to Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear. Be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific. An untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians, I guess.
We made a bit of money on that riverboat job, but not enough for us to leave and live peacefully. Where's the rest coming from?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place?
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing. I don't know if you have noticed, but we are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days before the Pinkerton show, and then, well, we're done. Now, we need money. Bronte said this place has got money. Come on!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Behave as I tell you, and none of you will die. Annoy me, and you all will. Now remember, we just want money. Don't make us kill you. Mr. M, leave these fine folks of their valuables.
Hand over all your money now.
I got this one.
Quick.
Dying.
Of course.
It's your choice, not mine. Kindly open that gate and let my acquaintance inside.
Now, I'm gonna need everything you got on
you.
There's nothing much here.
What?
Of course. There's nothing really here.
You're sure?
Yes.
Then get out here and get ready for company. All of you! Behave. We don't want to hurt any of you. Mr. M, check the safe.
Sure. Open it.
I don't think they keep much cash in there.
Open it! Almost nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it.
Damn!
We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Come on now! We got you surrounded!
That greasy son of a bitch! He set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time for sarcasm to you, Arthur.
What we gonna do, gentlemen?
Something! The trolley. The trolley! Follow me, gentlemen!
Go!
Now!
Does this trolley go to Tahiti?
I hope so. Oh. Hold them off, fellas. Look out on the right.
Hold up! Ah! Shit!
Now's our chance! Let's go!
Keep that wagon intact, okay? We might need it.
I think we're clear.
You know what, Dutch? Next time, let's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Don't mention it.
Yeah.
You're a good kid.
And we each got $15. Oh, and a quarter. Don't forget the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up. Played me like a yokel. Put the law on us. What did we do to him? What did I do to him?
I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, what are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need money. One more decent take, and we're gone. The bank is our bet. Hosea agrees.
Even after that?
Especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on. I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey, you did real good there, Lenny. Just wish it could have turned out better.
Well, you can't win them all.
Look out!
Evening.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus!
Yeah!
I won't die to know!
Let's go, bro.
Hey there.
Easy. You all right, girl? Okay, then. Slow up.
job.
Yep. Easy, whoa. Easy. Easy now. Get up. Thank you. Yep. Yep. Yeah.
Hey, hey! Yep.
Okay, then. There we go. Come on, girl. Idiot. Yep. Easy. We got a trail. I better get moving. Reckon I got a ways to go. Must be close. Thank you. girl. Yeah. My girl.
Yeah.
There we go.
Back. Go on, have yourself a quick nosy. After a little tchotchke, are we? If you've been struggling to sell a little something, give me a try. You want to know how to turn shit and stones to bread? Ask a country boy. Pretty here, bet you're thinking. Well, close your eyes and smell the cow shit. I never asked a question about an acquisition in my life. All sorts of unusual ways to acquire goods in this world. I'm not one to judge.
Thanks, Mister.
It's been a little while, eh? So, buying or selling? All right, let's have a look. Done. Yep.
Real good doing business with you.
All made to measure. Okay, let's take a look at it.
Sure.
Thanks for your help.
Nothing quite like wearing your best day's work. There. What do you think?
Sets the clothes, babe.
Yep.
See the bind I'm in. I need help again. Come on!
Hey, mister. Oh, hey, friend.
You boys don't look so fresh.
We ain't.
I think we're dying, friend.
We ate some bad mushrooms.
Bad business, sure.
It's been real tough, partner.
So it seems.
I hate to ask, but we need some medicine. Kind of fast.
Medicine?
Yeah, look at us. Look at me. And he's worse than he looks.
Oh.
And he looks like shit. He ain't gonna last 3 days. And me, I ain't well. Not at all.
Not at all.
I'm begging you, partner. Why? I told you you'd help us. I told you. I told you, did I?
You did. You told me. You told me a lot of things.
We're gonna be all right, buddy.
Are we?
Well, physically. Drink this.
I'll give it to Black first.
No. I'll give it to White.
No, no.
Drink this and shut up.
Thank you.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Ooh. But listen. I reckon you boys should get on out of here. Maybe split up. Head up north or overseas. They don't like groups of men. I know.
I hear you, boss.
It's time. Oh, once we're better.
I mean, I can't wait to be rid of you.
Embarrassing?
Yeah, you're an embarrassment.
Well, be embarrassed no more. Get back to the...
Yep. Easy now.
Easy. Whoa. Okay, then.
You see any welcome sign around here? Go on with you.
Let's see you.